I'd like to welcome you all here this evening. We're going to be doing a rock and roll show for all the people here in the Holland area. All we can say is we're very happy to be here and hope you all have a wonderful, wonderful time. Thank you.
Can't you see the red light is on?
There was a defining moment when I was a kid where I knew that I wanted to do music. Not necessarily sing and songwrite, but I wanted to do music, and I was really young. I was really close to my family. We had a big family. It was beautiful, wonderful, loving, wonderful vibe. And my brothers and sisters all took piano. So one night in the middle of the night, I got up, I was four, and I went in, I sat on the piano, and I started playing La Sonata, and my whole family came out and were like, "No way, dude!" And I was just like this on the piano. Like, I was so happy, he's getting so much attention and love, and I loved that. That was something that I can't explain to you. I felt so like I belonged, and I felt like I was doing something that was right for me to be doing, you know, and wasn't very good or nothing like that, but it was that feeling. When I play music, I just think of that. I think of family, and I think of belonging, and you know, obviously if it's a show and people don't like you and they throw shit at you, then it's not, you know, a sense of belonging. But if it's a one like last night at Paradiso, that's that feeling of the family coming out in the middle of the night and going, yeah.
Hello, Amsterdam. Put your hands together and make some fucking noise. Beth Hart.
Can't believe it. It's so nice, man. It's a trip. Oh, yeah, we got a deal. What was our deal, man? What was our deal?
That's right.
In fact, I think I'm going to start with that.
Some people won't show up to Paradiso because of the rain?
No. Really? No, it's typical Dutch weather, so they're used to it. They just want to sit inside tonight, you know?
Yeah. So we're almost done with this. I'm sad. It'll be the best show. It'll be the highest spirit show. And by this time too, a lot of the people that are gonna be here tonight, we played for this past week, and the band's all warmed up, and I'm kicked the shit out of, and it'll be nice and real. I was so crabby last night though, David. Poor Scotty. I want Scotty to know that I love him so much, and I'm really sorry for being so crabby. And also, David, I'm sorry for being so crabby sometimes too. I love him. Well, I can get pretty crabby.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know what she's talking about. I really don't. You know? Everything is always so calm and cool.
I think that on this record in particular, more than any record I've done before, I let be known through the songs how much I've been influenced by other artists, particularly Otis Redding, huge fan. Edith James, God bless her. Aretha Franklin, huge fan. Janis Joplin, obviously huge fan. Robert Plant, huge fan. I mean, the list goes on for me. All of these artists seemed like they had all a desperation to connect. So when I heard those artists, I love them because it made me feel like I wasn't alone.
Did you take it too far? Did you forget who you are? Did you smash your soul into the closet for your
So when I got a chance to get into the studio, it was like all of my favorite artists, I got to bring in that studio with me. I don't know if I interpreted those artists. I hope I did, because I love those artists. And I love that music. I love that soul and that desperate cry out to be heard, to belong.
I'm nervous.
Around the other way, yeah? Okay, we go this way. The new record, Leave a Light On, basically how that all came about was a lot of luck, I think, because when I was starting to feel a little bit better, I had called my manager and said, hey, I think that I'm ready to start working on a new record, if that's possible. And I knew we really didn't have a deal, but we had a little bit of ammunition and some energy there, and an opportunity opened up where I got to work with an amazing producer and songwriter whose name was Michael Bradford. But I was still very insecure, had no confidence. So I was really meek in the studio, and I started playing on his little guitar and playing the piano, a couple of things, and with my head down and my tail between my legs. And at the end of it, he turned to me and said, you don't need to write with me. He goes, you need to make a record. He goes, I think you're ready to go now. We started right away. We started the next week laying down demos and things. And it was great. It was very inspirational. It was also very hard. At this time in my life, I had zero confidence. And what was so great about working in the studio was I was with people who were so warm that it was very encouraging to me, you know? And then, of course, when you get inspired like that, you start writing more. Some of my favorite songs on the new album, I think Lifts You Up is a song that I really love, because when we play it, people seem to really genuinely be happy. When we're playing the song, a lot of energy, and that makes me stoked. Another song is Sky Full of Clover, because that's really the... I feel so proud about that song, because it's a direct writing song to God and my feelings about spirituality and faith, and that I know that I'm gonna be all right. It's like for so long I tried to control everything, and the more I tried to control, the more out of control I was. And I think coming into a place of realizing that if I turn my life over and just have faith that God's gonna guide me, that I'm gonna be wherever I need to be. It may not be my favorite day, but it's right where I need to be. And that song kind of sums up that kind of thinking. I really love Sky Full of Clover. So bruised up doing these shows up here. If I showed you guys my legs and my feet, you'd trip out. It looks like someone's been kicking the shit out of me, you know?
And in one way I like it because I feel like I'm working hard, but in another way I feel kind of like, I don't know, like it's just more kinds of, you know, abuse to myself or something weird or something, you know what I mean? And it's not that pretty looking.
Hey, Joyce.
Hi, David.
How are you?
How are you doing?
Good. How would you feel if instead of that, we did World Without You just in case I needed it twice? And we just eliminate this, so if I needed it twice, we could do it again at the very end.
After Immortal, I need something to calm down and just relax.
And World Without You doesn't accomplish that, huh?
No, it's very hard. Mm. World Without You, yeah. This song, I'm very, very thankful to have this song on the record. I think it's an amazing song. David Wolf, my manager, turned me on to the song from Oliver Lieber, who had written it with John Shanks. And Oliver Lieber produced L.A. Song, and he also produced Delicious Surprise from Screaming for My Supper. And then on this record, I had the opportunity to work with him on Light On. He helped me to finish write that song. And then at the very end, he said, hey, you know, we got this little song here and people seem to be responding well to it. Would you like to sing it? And I was just like, yeah, like begging, yeah, definitely. And he produced that as well. But it seems to be getting a really good response. I love the melody. It's very Beatlesque. It's cool. Painted pictures spilling from my walls. The dangerous cross. Was it yesterday? I don't know. Was I dreaming? Or did I lose everything? We've got so many shows here that we did over the last whatever. You know, you kind of got to go by the audience. You kind of got to write a set list and then follow them. This record was different in terms of the recording process from Immortal and from Screaming for My Supper. There were certainly, of course, similarities. You know, you're going into the studio and I'm always nervous. I'm always nervous about everything. But I think what was so different also was a lot of things. I was married, had a new band. I think a lot more grown up than people I've worked with in the past. So there comes more of a relaxed feeling. And that was wonderful because I'm so spun and wound up tight. To work with people that are really relaxing is good for me. The whole experience of just having my ass kicked, I think was the best thing for recording. Because when you come in there, when I came in there and I was kind of like beaten down feeling, I think it enabled me to stay out of my way and just let it flow. Whereas before, maybe being too cocky, you come in, you get in your own way because you're trying to control. And I was really willing to work with others on this record. And try anything, everything, and just go with the flow. And so I think that made for a more cohesive record, more of an honest record, maybe. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Check, check, check. 1, 2.
Nice.
Can we go to the center vocal now?
Hey. Check, check. 1, 2. All right. Beautiful. Eric, if you have a little more headroom, that'd be cool.
I mean, what inspires me is just being moved, you know, and there's so many things that happen in the course of a day, in an hour, and it's usually, I mean, sometimes it's by nature, just looking at the world and you see things and you get to see how beautiful this world that we live in really is. It's amazing. Nature is like, God is the rock and roll artist of all time. That is very inspirational. But also, you know, like people, just seeing how people work with each other. I'll tell you something though, I used to inflict a lot of self-pain thinking that would help me to write, which it did. But then I realized I do not need to create drama in my life because life is gonna kick me in the ass no matter what. All I gotta do is hang in there, take care of myself, and it's gonna take me on my ups and downs. When I tend to write the most is when I'm in the most pain
or, you know, joy, but more pain, which is kind of a bummer because, you know, you don't want to be in pain. But that's when I write. I think it's when I'm forced to just be exhausted and give up, and then the writing happens.
I seen myself with a dirty face. I cut my luck with a dirty ace. I leave the light on. I leave the light on. I went from zero to minus 10. I drank your wine, then I stole your man. I leave the light on. I leave that light on.
I like Leave the Light On because it's like, I think it was the song that really said how I was feeling coming into the beginning parts of sobriety. And kind of chronicling how things were as a kid and then as a teenager and in my early 20s when I'd gotten with Atlantic and I was really on a spiral trying to get up, but I couldn't because I was in so much fear and holding on that it just spun me right down. And I think that the bottom line with that fear was trying to be something that I thought other people would like me for when that person was not being myself. I was too afraid to be myself. I thought that I would be rejected or that any opportunity would be taken away from me if, God forbid, anybody saw who I was. And behaving that way really took my life down. So ironically, it's when I started to become myself that I think that like I got married and better opportunity in music and I'm happier. It's easier to live just as you are than trying to put on that front, you know? And Light On, I think, definitely talks about that. It's just wanting to learn how to live and how to love. Yeah.
I leave the light on. Better leave the light on. 'Cause I wanna love. I wanna live. I don't know much about it.
I think that whether it's art, whether it's medicine, whether it's whatever it is you're passionate about, you're gonna suffer. I think that's just life. That's just the trade-off, you know? If you're fortunate enough to find something and then believe in yourself enough to work at it, a passion, you're gonna have pain too. There's no free ride, not for any of us. And I don't mind.
A special little song from my grandpa. This is the shortest song.
Yeah. Go ahead. Oh, they're on?
15 minutes.
I took the Christian room, so okay, you got 15 minutes.
Okay. You ready?
Let me see your shades. What do you have?
Yeah, they're upstairs.
Let me get Josh's shades real quick, too.
This album is definitely the most personal work. There's no doubt about it. And I think it's for, you know, a lot of reasons, man. And I just babble. But what comes to mind is that no one was looking. You know, there was really no pressure on this record. And as far as I was concerned, I had blown it so bad with the last album that I thought that even when I finished this record, no one would be looking. So it was a chance to just go in with your band, with my band, with the producer I trusted, and get to work and let it go. I had gotten so messed up with the drinking and the drugs that I couldn't even walk or talk properly for a long time. And I remember the doctors telling me, forget about music, you're not even gonna be able to have a job. You're not even gonna be able to have kids. You're gonna just be nuts. You've messed your mind up. And they had told me that. They gave me a whole stack of papers saying that this is it, you're a goner, kid. And I remember a certain point, I just refused to believe it. At first I was believing it. Yeah, I wanted to go along those lines. But at a point, I remembered who I used to be, that I used to be strong and healthy and have a passion. What else was I gonna talk about, you know? I wanted to talk about, I wanted to get it out there. What I'd been through and how grateful I was to be alive again and hopefully get that message across to anyone that was out there thinking that they had messed up so bad, maybe they should just take themselves out. No, because everybody messes up. That's a part of being a human being and learning. I don't think we really learn until we really hurt our foot or touch that fire and burn our hand. We don't really learn to not touch the stove, you know?
Yeah, I'm gonna throw my lover out with the bathwater while I jive, jab, and rhyme, baby. No, we ain't. No, we ain't two of a kind. I say black, you say white. You get along, but I like a good fight. We're just the same as mixing water and oil. I don't get along with you anymore.
Dear God up in heaven, we love you so much and we thank you so much for our health, for our lives, for our families, for our friends. We pray for all the people out there right now who's struggling or not able to make some music tonight. There's something going on they're feeling unhappy about. It. We really thank you for letting us make some music tonight.
Thank you.
And we hope that we just pull together and give these people a lot of love and a lot of encouragement, a lot of light. Make it a positive show. And please, God, help me not to cuss so much. I love you so much, Jesus. Amen.
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 That's
right. Okay, man.
Yeah. Rock him, rock him.
I just want to give you a hug.
I love you.
Mom, I love you.
Thanks for this, David.
Let's go.
You want?
Really, thank you.
And you know what?
Okay.
Have a good time.
I don't
for coming. God bless you guys. Good night.
Y'all come back here and get
that was some fun.
Oh, yeah.
A little bit of something, maybe something softer. How about that? I play so hard anyway, you know?
Like the hard metal guys, and I love the male rock and rollers, man. They just, woo, sexy, sexy, sexy. Mm-hmm. So this next song is, we're big fans of these guys, and it's called I Don't Need No Doctor, Bitch.
I don't need no doctor.
cooked a chicken. Thought it was a duck. Put it on the table with its legs wrapped up. All my pains and my ills. Said I love you. Said I love you. Said I love you. Ah, said I love you. Hey, said now I don't need no doctor. I don't need no doctor. I don't need no doctor. Thank you for coming. God bless you guys. Good night.